Sejin here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create your own custom picture-in-picture talking avatar, perfect for your YouTube persona or for any of your other social media platforms. Picture-in-picture is a popular video mode where you have the main video and a smaller floating video of the YouTuber narrating the main video. It makes your content way more engaging and increases viewer retention to help you go viral. Plus, many people seem to really love it. If you like this sort of content, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. We need to generate a character that matches the persona we're looking for. I want to create a cool looking hacker character in a Pixar style, so I came up with this prompt. A young man in a Pixar style, looking straightforward, wearing a burgundy hoodie, hacker style, cyberpunk colors, clean white background. Feel free to change it up with your own style, such as an anime style, a realistic style, and so on. I ran the prompt through Midjourney, DALL-E 3, and Gemini to get a variety of options. I'm going to go with DALL-E since the image came close to what I was looking for. The next step is to remove the background from the image. Go to pixelcut.ai. While there's a ton of AI background removers, PixelCut is the best when you want to accurately and cleanly remove all the background from the picture. Click on Tools, then Background Remover, upload your image. Once it's done, download your image. Now it's time to animate your character using HeyGen. Go to HeyGen. If you've never used HeyGen before, use the link in my description to get a free credit to generate your own avatar. Once you signed up, click on Photo Avatar and upload your character by clicking on the Upload Talking Photo. Once uploaded, hover your mouse over Create Video and choose either a landscape or portrait template. I'll choose a landscape template. With your template set, click Photo Avatar and click on your character. Let's change the background color to a green screen color. Right click on the background, select Scene Background. In the hexadecimal box, input the following code, 00FF00. Looks good. Now we want to drop in our audio voice file that we recorded using our own voice, so make sure to have that ready before you generate your avatar. If you don't want to use your own voice, I recommend clicking on the video that's popping on top to learn how to generate the best realistic AI voice. In this video, I'm going to show you how you click the submit button to start generating. Once it's done, click the download button. Now it's time to choose the video background for our character. If you already have a media source, then feel free to use that. If not, go to pexels.com. Pexels is the best free stock photo and video site on the net, so let's search for some videos. I think a space background will look cool, so I'll search for space. This looks nice. Just click on the video you want to download. Click the down arrow button to choose the video size. And click Download Select Size. Feel free to choose any additional video or image you want to use as your background. Now, it's time to put it all together. Open up the CapCut app. If you don't have CapCut, you can download the app version or the desktop version from CapCut.com. With CapCut open, let's import all our assets into the media folder. Now, let's drag our character with the green screen into the timeline. Click Cutout, then click Chroma Key. Use the color picker to sample the green area. Then increase the strength and the shadow to 100%. Now we need to adjust the size and placement of the character so it appears exactly as it should in the video. I'll click on the image to adjust the size and adjust it a bit so it fits perfectly in the corner. Now let's drop in our space background for the character and make sure the character video sits on top of the background video. Then I'm going to adjust the size and placement of the background video so that my character looks like he's in space. I'll cut off the excess length on the background video so it aligns with my character video by clicking the delete right button. Do some minor adjustments. Now before we start masking, you can add additional videos to the background video so that it keeps changing. I'm going to keep this one to keep things simple. Now highlight both videos and right click. Click on create compound clip to combine both videos into one. Let's click on mask. You can choose a circle, rectangle, or even a heart-shaped mask. I prefer the circle mask. Move the circle mask over to the character and adjust the size and position until it fits perfectly. Let's leave some room on the bottom if you plan to use the outer ring style. Let me test it. Show you how you can create your own picture-in-picture talking avatar for your YouTube videos. Looks good to me. Now, let's make the outer ring. Click on the text option. Drag and drop the default text box to the timeline. Change the default text to the letter O. Now we want the ring to be perfectly circular and thin, so I'll use the Objective Thin font. I'll change the color to something close to a cyan color. Okay, now I'm going to adjust the size and carefully place it over my character so that it aligns perfectly with my character's profile. If you want, you can add a little glow effect to make it look cooler and futuristic. You can adjust the intensity of the glow to your liking. Let me increase the duration of the outer ring by dragging the text box to align with the video and the timeline. Now with your own custom avatar perfectly set, you can now add your main video to the timeline. Make sure your main video is on the bottom of the timeline. Hey, if you don't want to use your own voice for the avatar, you should definitely watch this video.